सर्वकृतं महाकायस्य कोटि समप्र निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा पागर्थाय संपृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ अक्षरस्वाम्नायमधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृष्णं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनेय नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणु धातुर्ब्रह्मैव सम्प्रोक्तो जीवाख्यात उच्यते प्रकृति कृत्सबद्धानि धातुर्ब्रह्मात्मने नमः शुक्लां ब्रह्मविचारसारं आद्यां जगद्व्यापिनी Just give me a moment, please. Is the screen there?
Yes.
Close the window. The laghu prayer is Natvam Sarasvatim Devim Shuddham Gunyam Karomiham Paninim Praveshaya Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudim. Okay. So there was some disconnect in the last part. So I'll just go back one sutra and look at this Adyanta Utakito. So Adyanta Takito and Midachyontyat Paraha, these are the sutras which tell you where to add the Agama. So the Kittagama and Tittagama are which go at Tittagama and Kittagama go at the Adi and Anta of the entity to which the Agama is ordained. So the example we were looking at this Lung Lung Lungshu Rungshu Adudattaha. So At Udattaha is the swara for at, and that at agama being a tit agama, it should go to the adi of what? So lung lung rungshu saptami bahuvachana. Therefore that which follows is the lung lung or lring pratya. So any of these tiptas ji or ta tamja ityadi in lung lung or lring lakara, when they are added, then what precedes is the anga, and that anga which happens to be the dhatu plus vikarna pratya, Gana Vikarna Pratya, that will take the Tit Adagama. And where should it go to the Anga? Starting with the Dhatu, beginning with the Dhatu, it will go at the Adi. Being Tit, it will go to Adi, and thereby you get Abhavat Ityadi. So Bhudhatu, Anga becomes Bhav plus A of Shap being a first Gana Vikarna Pratya. So Bhava is the Anga, and when Ti is added in the sense of the lung lakara, let's say, then what happens is that adagama goes to the beginning of the anga. So bhava will become abhava, and this ti changes to takara because ikara lopa takes place in any nit lakara, thereby you get the form abhava. So this was the example for tit. For the adyantu takito, then for kit, so this tuk agama. So we are looking at this harasvasya piti kriti tuk. So tuk is an agama, this tuk agama is a kit agama, the content is actually tuk. So tuk is takara is the content, kakara is an it letter, ukara is an it letter by upadeshi jamnasika it, and kakara by halantyam. So kakara goes away, tuk is a kit agama. Where should it go? So it is ordained kriti pare, piti kriti pare. When a pit krit pratyaya follows, then the anga which is hraswa, hraswanta anga. So what is that anga to which the krit pratyaya is added? Krit pratyaya is added to a dhatu, dhatoho pratyaya parascha. Therefore the dhatu will take tugagama. So when the tugagama is added to a dhatu, which is a pitkrit pratyaya, when the pitkrit pratyaya is following, then the hraswanta, it should be a dhatu ending with a hraswa, it will become hrut, because say it will become dhatu plus sudhatu. So for example, the hru dhatu, you take hru dhatu, or let's say kru dhatu, easier, kru dhatu. So kru dhatu is a hraswa ending dhatu. Hraswa rukara is the ending letter, and when the pith krit pratyaya is added, so which is a pith krit pratyaya, let's say twa pratyaya is added, twa is a krit pratyaya, which is a kith pratyaya, but it is not a pith pratyaya. So twa, but then twa, let's say kru takes a v upasarga, so v plus kru, then what will happen here? But this twa pratyaya is replaced by lyap pratyaya, and when this lyap pratyaya is a pit pratyaya, and it is also kit because it is a replacement for twa, then you will get vikritya. Vikritya, this kind of a form, because tugagama is added to kru. Kru dhatu, where should it go? It will go, being a kit, it will go at the anta. So we will get V plus kru will become krut, and then the lyap content is here. Lyap content is here, not in the bracket, here in the bracket. So lyap content is here, so you will get vikritya. So something like that. So these are the means, something like that, as an example is something like that. Then midachontyat paraha mit. Mit agama, makara being an itina agama, where should it go? Antyat achaha paraha, it will go to the end of the vowel of the anga. So the anga is the, let's say, dhatu, and mit agama is given. So example, let's look at if there is a mit example. So ida idito num dhato ho. So there is a num is an agama. Num is an agama, content is nakara. So when this nakara is ordained in a mith agama, where should it go? Dhato ho. It will go to the dhatu. Which kind of a dhatu? Which is an idit dhatu. So example given is nadi. Nadi is ikara is an ith letter. Therefore it is it in ikara. Hraswa ikara is called as ith. And that ith is an ith letter. So hraswa ikara with taparakarna is called as ith. And what is the second ith? Id. This id is the first ith, which says that the hraswa ikara by tapara karanam is there in the nadi dhatu. And that ikara, hraswa ikara, happens to be an ith letter which will go away. Therefore, id, ith, ith meaning ikaraha, ith, ikaraha, ith, yas, yasmin dhato ho, yasmin. यस्य धातु और यस्मिन धातु, सो इन विच धातु, नदी हियर एग्जाम्पल, दैट धातु इकारा इज एन इथ लेटर, दैट इज एन इदित धातु. सो आफ्टर द इदित धातु, इदितः धातु हो नुम आगमा भवति, दैट इज एग्जाम्पल ऑफ मिथ. सो वेयर शुड इट गो? सो दिस नुम आगमा कंटेंट इज नकारा, दिस विल बी प्लेस्ड आफ्टर द लास्ट वॉवेल ऑफ द धातु. So the last level of the dhatu, nad, nadi, ikara will go away and then it will become nad. So nad has three letters, nakara, akara and dakara. So this akara is the last vowel of the dhatu. Antya mid achontyat para, so antya ach is this akara, and after this the nakara of the num agama will go, and therefore the form will be nand. So the dhatu will become nand. That is the example for midachontyat paraha being applied, paribhashika sutra. Then there is one paribhashika sutra called urandra paraha. So ra is a pratyahara, ayun riluk, ayun riluk, a ong, then I ouch ha ya va rat. So and then Hayavarat and then Lund. That Lund Sutra has an Anuswara. So not Ardhachandra, but yeah, so this is Lund Pratyahara. So this Akara is not for Uccharanartha. This Akara, which is nasalized, is an eighth letter. So all the Ayun Sutra and such, all the Akaras which are added, they are for Uccharana, because the consonants cannot be pronounced on their own. But in the Lund Sutra, Lund Madhyetu, Itsanyaka says Laghuvritti there. So this is Itsanyaka, Akara. And this is also used to make a Pratyahara in Ra. So Ra is Repha and Lakara both, really. So Ayun Reel A Om Hayavarat, that Repha Ra, then La. So Repha and Lakara are part of this. So Ra and La, Repha and Lakara Paraha. So Ra means Repha and Lakara. So Uhu, Uhu An, Uhu An is what? Ra Paraha. So whenever Uhu is Shashti Ekvachana of An is one and one one, Prathama Ekvachana. Uhu is Shashti Ekvachana of Rukara. So this, because Dhatru Shabda will become Dhatuhu in Panchami and Shashti Ekvachana. So Ru will become Uhu. So that is that Uhu. Ru, when it is replaced by An, A, E, U, Ril. So An here is the, whenever the, say for example, Guna takes place. Ru takes a Guna, so Ru's Guna is Akara. So when Ru is replaced by Akara, that is an Anadesha for Ru. Or Ru is replaced by Akara, which is a Vriddhi. So by Guna or Vriddhi, Ru, when it is replaced by Akara or Akara, or Lu is replaced by Akara or Akara by Guna and Vriddhi respectively, because Ru and Lu, Guna is Akara and Vriddhi is Akara. Then that Akara or Akara will be Ra Paraha, meaning by proximity of pronunciation, Sthane Antaratamatvam, Ru will be replaced by A due to Guna, and then this Ru has a content of Repha, so to say. Therefore, kind of a Repha sound is there, so it is very close in proximity. The Sthana is same. Therefore, Repha will be added after this Akara. So, An will be Ra Paraha An. As soon as A is replacing Ru, that A will be replaced by some other sutra, whatever sutra it is, but as soon as that replacement takes place, then Uran Rapara will come into play and will make that A as Ar. A is Guna, but Ar is not Guna, but A will become Ar, and Vriddhi is A, but A will become R. Similarly, when Lu is replaced by A, there is a Lakara sound equivalent to Rakara sound, that Lakara will come and join this A. So although A is the Guna, Al is not the Guna, A is Guna, Al will be the Adesha. Similarly, A as a Vriddhi for Lakara will be followed by Ra Paraha Lakara, and you will get Al. So that is the Paribhashika Sutra application of Uran Ra Paraha. Then whenever Guna and Vriddhi are ordained as Adeshas, what should take Guna and Vriddhi? So this is called as Iglakshana Guna Vriddhi. When nothing is specifically mentioned that this particular letter should take Guna or Vriddhi, unless a specific identification is there in the sutra itself, then the Guna and Vriddhi will take place for an Ik in the Sthani. So only Ik can take Guna. So Ikaha should be added. How do you get that? So that is through Iglakshana Guna Vriddhi, this sutra. Iko Guna Vriddhi. Guna Vriddhi is Prathama Dvivachana and Ikaha is Shashti Ekvachana. So Ikaha Sthane Eva Guna Vriddhi Bhavataha. So Guna and Vriddhi take place only in the Sthana of Ik. So Ikaha can be added there whenever Guna Vriddhi is not clear as to where it will take place in the Sthani. These will be covered anyway in the sutra. Then whenever Hraswa Dirgha Pluta Adeshas are given, Hraswa Dirgha and Pluta can take place only for Ach. Therefore, Achascha Sutra comes into play and achascha has an anuvritya of hrasva dirgha plutaha. So only this achaha can be added in the sutra wherever there is hrasva dirgha plutaha ordained. So hrasva adesha will be for ach, and that will not be clear because the sthani is identified, but what will take guna hrasva dirgha plutaha adesha is not clear. There you can add achaha by this achascha sutra, and then the vritti will have achaha from this sutra which is elsewhere, which is there in the number of this sutra is 1 to 28. If you have some dirgha ordained in the angakarya in the 6th chapter, there also you can use this and bring achascha, and achaha can be placed in the vritti. So achaha hrasvaha, achaha dirgha, the vritti will read like that. So these are the 5 different types of sutras categorization that we have seen. Then there is an Atidesha Sutra. 6th category is Atidesha Sutra. Atidesha Sutra is extension. So here example is a Sthanivad Adesho Analvidhau is an Atidesha Sutra. So says that Sthanivat Adesha is Sthanivat, meaning here the example is given. So Lyap is an Adesha to Tva Pratyaya. We saw an example with kru plus tva becomes v plus kru plus lyap. So this the dharmas of tva will apply to the, so tva is a krut pratyaya and a kit pratyaya. Kakara is an it, therefore this it will apply to lyap also. Lyap will also enjoy the status of being a kit pratyaya, although lyap does not have a kakara at all, let alone being a kit pratyaya. It is a pit pratyaya, all right, it is a lit pratyaya, all right, but it is not a kit pratyaya as seen in the construct lyap. But it is also a kit pratyaya because the adesha will hold on to the dharmas of tva, which is the sthani. So sthani vad adesha lyap is also sthani vat, tva sthani vat, tva is the sthani, so sthani is kit, so kidvat. Lyap is also tvavat, meaning kidvat. It will also be like a kit pratyaya. So that is the example there in the Atidesha. So that is extension. Whatever is the dharma of the tva pratyaya sthani, that is extended to the adesha also. So it is an Atidesha Sutra. Then there is a categorization called Nishera Sutra. Nishera Sutra is just negating whatever, there is no vidhi there. So you block some vidhi which was there to come into play, you want to restrict it. Therefore this Nisheda Sutra is what, so Purva Sutra Karya Nishedaka Sutram Nisheda Sutram. Nisheda Sutram is that sutra which will block the earlier vidhi from the earlier sutra. Some sutra is already known, so that vidhi should apply. Now another sutra comes into play which blocks that vidhi to apply in a particular scenario, that is a Nisheda Sutra. We have seen that example at the beginning, na vibhaktau tusmaha. So halantyam is the adesha, which is a vidhi which was already given. Halantyam it syat. Now the vibhaktau tusmaha says in the vibhakti antya hal is not it letter. So that is a nisheda sutra. Then there is a concept called utsarga and apavada. Utsarga is a general rule. Apavada is restricting that rule by negation. So there, apavada is a nisheda of the utsarga. So general rule does not apply. So that is an apavada. So the broad structure of utsarga and apavada, the relation is utsarga is broader, apavada is a subset of that. So utsarga is savakasha. Savakasha means it has many avakashas. Avakashayas avakashaihi sah vartate iti savakasha. There are many avakashas, application areas for utsarga, which is a general rule. General rule always apply at most places. Now this apavada is niravakasha. Niravakasha means apavada is that sutra which if not given an opportunity in a particular area, it will never get an opportunity to apply. So it will become vyartha. That sutra is called an apavada sutra. So the apavada sutra takes priority over utsarga sutra. So if there are two sutras which are applicable in a particular scenario, then the apavada sutra should be applied. If it does not get any application area beyond what is the scenario, so in that scenario if the general sutra is also applicable and this particular sutra is also applicable, then this particular specific sutra should take priority. That is an apavada to general, because utsarga will apply in other areas. Then general sutra can apply in other scenarios where this apavada sutra cannot apply. Then there is something called niyama sutra also, which limits. So nisheda negates, but niyama sutra limits. We saw in the last patha that whenever there is already a vidhi given, then another vidhi is also given, meaning generally one broad vidhi is given that will apply anyway in a particular scenario, and then there another vidhi is given which would have otherwise also through the earlier vidhi applied, so that rule would have fructified in the same result. Then why is the vidhi mentioned again in another way? So this punaha vidhi, that again the vidhi given is to limit, restrict the scope of the earlier vidhi. That is a niyamana sutra or a niyama sutra. So what we saw as a siddhe sati arabhyamanam niyamaya, meaning siddhe sati punararambha, that vidhi siddhe sati means vidhi which was already given. Vidhau siddhe sati punararambha niyamanartham. So that is for niyamana, restriction of the earlier broad scope to a very particular area. All this introduction and history and all that I'll skip. We'll directly go to the sutras now. So there is a dhyana shloka which I suddenly recalled, which I was chanting, and then I realized that lagu shloka is later. So this is somehow stuck in the mind, but not completely. So we used to do these in the earlier patha. So the after our set of chants, which are common to classes, vyakarana classes, we'll chant these also. And I recalled that end of the this thing we used to chant how the Maheshwara Sutra came in. So Nrityavasani Ityadi. So if I recall, we'll chant that. Otherwise, our general prayer would do. So anyway, for the sake of completion, I'll just chant it. Sanya Sutra, because Lagu begins here. Ayun Rilut Eung Ayouch Hayavarat Lan Yamananam Jhavai Ghadadash Jabagadash Khapachata Chatatav Kapai Shasasar Hal Iti Maheshwarani Sutrani. So with this, the Maheshwara Sutras, the Lagu starts and says that these are what? These 14 sutras, iti Maheshwarani Sutrani, they are 14 in number, and they are used for pratyahara. So now you go to the first sutra is Halantyam in Lagu. So this is where the Lagu Siddhanta Kaumudi proper starts. Halantyam, we have seen Upadeshe It. So Lagu Vritti is what? Upadeshe Antyam Hal Itsya. The last consonant in an Upadesha is an It letter. So Sutreshu Adrushtam Padam Sutrantarat Anuvartaniyam Sarvatra. And what is Upadesha? That is said as what? Upadesha Adyocharanam. The first chanted in what? In any works of the Munitraya, that is considered Upadesha. And in that, Sutreshu Adrushtam Padam Sutrantarat Anuvartaniyam Sarvatra. This Anuvartti is explained as if the Sutra itself is what? Halantyam. There is nothing there. What do you know? Halantyam, Antyam Hal. If at all you try to understand it will be Antya Hal. What about that Antya Hal? So you don't know what to do. So there Upadeshe It, this has to be brought from the earlier sutra. That is said here as to Anuvritti is what? That Anuvartaniyam Sarvatra. Something should be brought down from the sutrantara, from other sutra. It need not be only preceding sutra. It can be preceding, not the immediately preceding, but some sutras earlier also. Or sometimes you see the sutra is the following sutra also. The sutra from which you bring the Anuvritti may also be following. So Sutreshu Adrushtam Padam, what is not seen in that particular sutra has to be brought from other sutras. This is a standard rule in any sutras, whether it is Brahma Sutra, Yoga Sutra or any Mimamsa Sutra, and similarly in Ashtadhyayi Sutra also, Pani Sutras, Vyakrana Sutras. So we have seen all this Adarshanam Lopaha. So what is Lopaha? Tasya Lopaha. Here we'll need, here if you look at this, this is the first sutra. Then इतः लोपः तस्य लोपः सूत्र हैज टू बी ब्रॉट सो देर दैट हैज टू बी एक्सप्लेन्ड एज टू व्हाट इज लोप सो ही ब्रिंग्स इन दिस सूत्र अदर्शनम लोपः दी लोपः इज व्हाट अदर्शनम इज कॉल्ड एज लोपः इन दी व्याकरण सूत्र यू सी दी वर्ड लोपः व्हाट डज इट मीन इट मीन्स अदर्शनम मीनिंग व्हाट वॉज देर अर्लियर नाउ यू डू नॉट सी इट मीनिंग इन दी प्रत्याहार इफ समथिंग इज एन इथ लेटर सो अ ई उण नकार इज एन इथ लेटर सो नकार वॉज सीन सीन मीनिंग हर्ड अ ई उण इन उच्चारण इट वॉज हर्ड अ ई उण दैट नकार गोज अवे मीनिंग अदर्शनम अदर्शनम प्राप्यते दैट अदर्शन इज कॉल्ड एज लोप सो प्रसक्त अदर्शनम लोपसन्यम स्यात् वॉट एवर इज एप्लीके आई मीन वॉट एवर इज seen in the context and then suddenly it goes away that is called as lopaha it is ordained by tasya lopaha so tasya lopa is the next sutra taken so tasya lopa tasya kasya tasya itaha lopaha so the laghuvritti se tasya itaha lopasyat lopa is what adarshanam syat ityartha the letter which is marked as it will undergo lopaha meaning adarshana meaning it will elide it will not be heard so when you say it as letter letter is uchcharita If you write it, it is seen. But then, what adarshana means here is that you don't hear. That's what the meaning is really. So na adeha ana adyarthaha. So this nakara ityadi in the ayun sutra, then ayun, then hayavarat that takara also na adeha means nakara takara. All these are what they are in the ana adyarthaha. They are all basically meant for pratyahara. Ana adyartha means an is un is one pratyahara so un in un all these are pratyahara short forms which are made by taking the last letter of each sutras in the maheshwara sutras so this nakara which is an ith letter in the sutra by halantyam tasya lopaha then why is it added it is added to make pratyaharas that is the sutra artha here adi antyena sahita then it has an anuruti of sasvasya adihi antyena sah ita ita sah सह गवन्स तृतीया सो इता इज थर्ड केस सिंगुलर ऑफ इत इता सह अलोंग विथ एन इत लेटर आदि ही एंड अंत्येन इता सह अंत्येन आदि ही अंत्येन इता सह आदि ही स्वस्य सो स्वस्य आदि ही स्वस्य स्वस्य षष्ठी एक वचन सो यू हैव टू रीड द वृत्ति टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज इट सो फार यू नो दैट आदि ही अंत्येन इता सह सो अंत्य इत इज वॉट ayun sutra in the ayun sutra nakara is an it so in the pratyahara you have an what is that an an is adihi akara in the ayun sutra and then nakara is the end letter which is an it letter so antyena nakarena itasah adihi akarah is what an pratyahara so that an pratyahara swasya swasya is what so you see antyena itasahitah sah sahitah आदि स्वस्य मध्यगानां च संज्ञा स्यात् सो इट स्टैंड्स फॉर इट्सेल्फ एंड व्हाट इज बिटवीन दी आदि लेटर एंड दी लास्ट लेटर सो लास्ट लेटर इज एन इथ लेटर सो इन दी अण अण सू अण प्रत्याहार विच अण अ ई उण वेर यू से अ ई उण यू हैव मेड अ शॉर्ट फॉर्म विथ अकार एंड नकार दिस इज अ प्रत्याहार अण So what is this an? What does an mean? So this sutra says adir antyena saheta. So adihi akara antyena nakarena sah ita nakarena sah, which is marked as an it by halantyam sutra. Along with that, what swasya akarasya adi akarasya and madhyaganam ikara ukaranam. Here it is only two. Therefore ikara ukarayoho. संज्ञा स्यात् सो अण् इति संज्ञा कस्य स्यात् आदि अकारस्य स्यात् इकारस्य अपि उकारस्य अपि सो वेन् यू से अण् अकार इकार उकार ऑल थ्री आर इन्क्लूडेड दैट इज दि मीनिंग ऑफ प्रत्याहार अण् विच इज अ शॉर्ट फॉर्म फॉर अ यू एंड व्हाट इज मध्यग मध्यग इज मध्ये गच्छन्ति इति मध्यगाः सो दोज विच आर बिटवीन दि आदि एंड दि अंत्य इत लेटर दे आर मध्यग सो हाउ डज शॉर्ट फॉर्म शुड एक्सटेंड दैट हैज बीन एक्सप्लेन्ड ऊकालो झ्रस्व दीर्घ प्लुतः सो दिस ऊकालो झ्रस्व दीर्घ प्लुतः इज वॉट ऊ कालः सो ऊकालः अच अच एंड देन ह्रस्व दीर्घ प्लुतः. सो अच इज हिडन हियर, अज, अज इज अच एंड देन ह्रस्व दीर्घ प्लुतः. सो व्हाट इज ऊकालः? सो ऊकालः इज बहुरिः दि उश्च ऊश्च ऊश्च ह्रस्व दीर्घ एंड प्लुत ऊ विल बिकम वहः एंड वह इज व्हाट? वह इज प्रथमा बहुवचन ऑफ उकार लाइक गुरुः गुरु गुरवः. सो गुरुः इन प्रथमा बहुवचन इज गुरवः. सो ऊ विल बी व्हाट? वहः. उकार व्हेन यू डिक्लाइन उकार और ऊ इट विल बिकम वह इन प्रथमा बहुवचन. एंड व्हाट इज द काल फॉर उकार ऊकार एंड ऊकार प्लुतः? त्रिमात्रिका. सो दिस इज एकमात्रिका, दिस इज द्विमात्रिका एंड दिस इज त्रिमात्रिका. सो व्हाट इज द उच्चारण फॉर उकार ऊकार एंड ऊकार दैट इज मेंट बाय वह हियर एंड इन उकाल दैट इज उका उकालः ऊकाल नॉट उकाल ऊकालः दैट ऊकालः इज अ समास विच सेज दैट विच एवर इज अ टाइम ड्यूरेशन नीडेड वॉट एवर इज अ टाइम ड्यूरेशन नीडेड टू प्रोनाउंस ऊ ऊ एंड ऊ थ्री मात्रास. सो ह्रस्व दीर्घ एंड प्लुता इज अ संज्ञा फॉर दोज. सो फॉर वॉट? वॉट एवर टाइम ड्यूरेशन इज टेकन बाय यू टू प्रोनाउंस उकार ऊकार एंड ऊकार विच टेक्स थ्री मात्रास. सो दिस इज वन मात्रा कंज्यूमिंग वन मात्रा, दिस कंज्यूम्स टू मात्रा, दिस कंज्यूम्स थ्री मात्रा. ह्रस्व दीर्घ एंड प्लुता दैट दीज आर कॉल्ड ह्रस्व दीर्घ प्लुता. सो दैट ड्यूरेशन वॉट एवर टेक्स दैट ड्यूरेशन. सो इकार टेक्स द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ दिस ऊ. सो इफ यू प्रोनाउंस ऊ फॉर वॉट एवर टाइम ड्यूरेशन यू हैव टू प्रोनाउंस द ह्रस्व इकार ऑल्सो इन दैट मात्रा. ईकार ऑल्सो सो एंड ईकार ऑल्सो सो विद द प्लुता. So what it is saying is that Hraswa Dirgha and Pluta are the sanyas which are given to the pronounced matras of these vowels with what as a reference? With this U, U and U as a reference. So the way a rooster sings in the morning as a wake up call, whatever sound it makes, you know that coo, coo and coo, Hraswa Dirgha Pluta is captured from whatever sound the rooster makes and there is an antargata U there. In the coo there is an antargata U there. That is considered as a standard to, as a reference to give Hraswa Dirgha and Pluta sanyas to these three particular matrika sounds, whichever vowel it is. So that is said here as the Bahuri, as what Vam Kala Iva Kala Yasya. So Vam means Shashti Bahuvachan of U. And whatever is the duration taken by U, U and U, all three, similar Kala, Iva Kala Yasya, whichever vowel has that, सह ऊ काल. सो अन्य पद यस्य अचह फॉर विच एवर वॉवेल टेक्स द सेम काला एज द काला टेकन बाय ऊ ऊ एंड ऊ दैट इज कॉल्ड एज ह्रस्व दीर्घ प्लुत. देन देर आर दी स्वरा विच आर टॉक्ड अबाउट उच्चैर उदात नीचैर अनुदात एंड देन समाहार स्वरित. दीज आर दी थ्री सूत्रास विच गिव दी स्वरा. So swaras are not that important, so I'll skip these. So you can look up as to the intonation as to how it is pronounced, they get these swaras. Then mukhanasika vachano anunasikaha. Anunasika is a sanya given to that sound which is pronounced by mukha and nasika, meaning what? Nasalized sound. So the laghu vritti says mukha sahita nasikaya उच्चार्यमाणः वर्णः अनुनासिक संज्ञा स्यात्. वॉट विल गेट द अनुनासिक संज्ञा? दैट विच इज प्रोनाउंस उच्चार्यमाणः वर्णः, दैट वर्ण विच इज उच्चार्यमाण विच इज बीइंग प्रोनाउंस विद वॉट? विथ मुख एंड नासिका. सो मुख सहित नासिका थ्रू दी नेजलाइज साउंड विच इज मेड द साउंड इज मेड थ्रू द माउथ बट इट इज नेजलाइज दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अनुनासिका. तदित्थम अ ई उ री एषाम वर्णानाम प्रत्येकम अष्टादश भेदाः. विद द अनुनासिका एंड द थ्री स्वराज ऑल्सो देर इज अ डिविजन ऑफ वॉवेल्स. सो वॉवेल्स आर ह्रस्व दीर्घ प्लुता, फर्स्ट सेट ऑफ थ्री डिविजन्स. सो देर इज ह्रस्व दीर्घ प्लुता बाय मात्रा. सो मात्राज विल गिव यू थ्री डिविजन्स ऑफ एनी वॉवेल. देन यू एड द स्वरा So swara, when you add, they are also three in number. So in 3 into 3 you will get 9. Then you have anunasika and ananunasika, nasalized and non-nasalized. So ananunasika bhedat, you will get 9 into 2 is equal to 18. So what they say is that this a, e, u and ru varnanam pratyekam ashtadasha bhedaha. There are 18 different ways to pronounce this with nasalization, non-nasalization, swarabheda, hraswa and dirgha and pluta. So the ayun sutra, a, e, u, ri, lri, lan, all these sutras, they, when they talk about a, they also include a and a in their swarabheda as well as in the nasalization and non-nasalization. Therefore a in the ayun sutra, e in the ayun sutra ityadi, they cover all the 18 varieties. So they do not have hraswa, dirgha, pluta, bheda mentioned within the sutra. Only a appears to be hraswa. But when you say a, then it includes a, a and with two, three swaras and two anunasika, nasalization, non-nasalization, they include all the 18. So it is marked here as to hraswa, dirgha, pluta of anunasika and ananunasika. And then udatta swarita anudatta bheda. So they, how they are marked in the text, that is mentioned here. This three at the end shows that it is pluta. And same for e, u and ru, because ru has a hraswa dirgha pluta, but lu, lukara does not have lu or lr, pronounced as ri also, some pronounced as ru. So that lu does not have a dirgha, therefore one dirgha will, one will drop off, so they'll have less, they'll have only 12 types. So lukara, this lu does not have dirgha. So dirgha lacking, there will be only 12 varieties. Similarly, ekara and aikara. Ekara and aikara and okara, aukara. So a, this is, sorry, I marked the wrong one here. Ekara, aikara, okara and aukara, they have only dirgha and pluta, they do not have hraswa. Just like this lu does not have a dirgha, these do not have hraswa. Hraswa is not there, therefore they are also 12 in number. But swarita, udata and anudata bheda is there, swara bheda is there, and there is a nasalized anunasika and ananunasika bheda, nasalized and non-nasalized. Therefore there are 12 varieties. Ekara, aikara, okara, aukara and lukara, they have only 12, not 18 varieties. In the Maheshwara Sutras, whatever is mentioned with aikara or lukara ityadi, they are all 12 in number. They cover all 12. Then the next sutra says, what is this prayatna? What causes something to be savarna? So, as in, what are part of the same varna? When you say a and a, they are all savarna. How do they get this savarna, savarnyam? How do they become savarna? So this sutra says what is savarna, meaning what is included in the same varna, same class. So when you classify letters, how do they get the same classification, which are different letters, how do they come under the same classification? So that is the due to the prayatna and asya. Tulyasya prayatnam savarnam. So tulya asya prayatnam savarna. So asya is sthana, where is your tongue touching, that is sthana. And prayatna is what? Abhyantara prayatna. Whatever effort you are taking, where it is your sound originating from, there in the vocal box, the air which is sent out through the mouth, where is it blocked? That is at the sthana. So there is some obstruction created at sthana by putting the tongue out there or on the floor, letting the air pass out of the mouth for uchcharana very clearly, because the mouth has to be opened for any sound to come out. Whenever you are pronouncing a consonant, that time a vowel has to be there, either preceding or following, for the sound to be produced, because with a closed mouth you cannot pronounce anything. So when you pronounce the letter, any letter, that will have to have a vowel, because as soon as you open the mouth, a vowel will have been pronounced, whether be it with the consonant or without the consonant, with the consonant preceding or following, but a vowel will have been pronounced. And then whenever a consonant is involved, then there is a sthana involved. Without the consonant also, pure vowel will also have a sthana involved, whether the tongue is touching a particular area of the mouth or it is resting on the floor. The sound will be produced when the mouth is opened, and that sound, whether it is going to hit the hand that you put in the front of your mouth or whether it will not hit the hand, that is the prayatna. With how much effort are you throwing the pronunciation out, as though the air out, which is the pronunciation. So thereby you see, you know, the when you talk about the varna, let's say varga, in the ka varga you have ka, kha, ga, gha, nya. So that ka, kha, ga, ka and ga do not have so much of air coming out of the mouth as the kha, gha, ka, the kakara, gakara, varna tritiya, varna prathama, varga prathama, varga tritiya and varga panchama, they are having less effort, whereas the varga dvitiya and varga chaturtha in all the five vargas have more effort. So that prayatna which is there, it shows the effort involved in throwing out the air. So kakara, khakara, gakara, ghakara have a bheda on prayatna. So that is the abhyantara prayatna. There will be a chart which will show that. Tulyav asya prayatnam yasya tat tulyasya prayatnam. Those which have a similar sthana and prayatna, they are called as tulyasya prayatna. And tulyasya prayatna, whichever has tulyasya prayatna, whichever letters have tulyasya prayatna, meaning asya and prayatna are similar, they are called as savarna. They share the same varna. So taluadi sthanam, so talu sthana, then murdhanya ityadi, they are sthana. So taluadi sthanam abhyantara prayatnascha iti etad dvayam yasya varnasya yena aparena varnena tulyam tat varnaha mitas savarnam sanyam sya. So savarna means the x is savarna to y, then y is also savarna to x. They share the same varna. So the savarna is mutual. That's what is mentioned in the laghuvritti. The Vartika here says ru ru varna your mitha savarnyam vachyam. Here this ru and ru varna are not included. They also should be mentioned, because ru has a different prayatna than lu. Lu is dantya, ru is talavya. But between ru and lu there is a savarna. That should have been mentioned. There is a Vartika which is extending the sutra meaning to be applicable. The definition of savarna should apply also to ru and ru, although they have different asya prayatna, they should be put together, because we see this in the sutra application. Then there are these vrittis which say akuha visarjaniyam kantaha ichuyashanam taluhu rutarashanam murdha, then rutulasanam dantaha upupadmaniyanam oshtau न्यमगणानानाम नासिकाच एदयितौ कंठतालु ओदौतौ कंठौष्टम वकारस्य दंतौष्टम जिह्वामूलस्य जिह्वामूलम नासिका अनुस्वारस्य. सो ऑल दीज आर द स्थानास मेंशन्ड फॉर डिफरेंट लेटर्स विच कम टुगेदर इन वन वर्ण. सो दीज आर देयर इन दी टेबल ऑल्सो इन मेनी बुक्स. सो दीज कैन बी लुक्ड अप एज टू विच लेटर हैज विच स्थाना in pronunciation. Then yatna dvida abhyantara bahyascha, prayatna is dvida, bahya prayatna and antara prayatna, both are there. Sorry. So adya panchada sprushta isha dvivruta vivruta samvruta bhedat. So how much is the mouth open, or is it, you know, little open, completely open, and whether the tongue is touching sprushta. In the sthana, the tongue is completely touching, or isha sprushta, whether it is touching a little. Isha dvivruta, the mouth is slightly open, vivruta completely open, samruta kind of closed with these bhedas. There is adhyaha means in the yatnaha dvividha abhyantara bahyascha. So abhyantara prayatna is panchada, is of these five types. Then it is explained as to which kind of letters has the sprishta ityadi. I'll skip these. I mean, I'll be doing the entire vritti. So we'll just look at the sutras, these prayatnas and all letters. I'm assuming that they are there. We have done a lot of these. I'm going to skip these. A lot of vritti here. We'll go to sutra proper, which will be useful. So varna categorization all can be studied on their own if it has not been studied earlier. So anudis savarnasya cha pratyaya swasya. Now here, when the adesha agama ityadi talk about something there, anudis savarnasya cha pratyaya, this savarna has been mentioned. Where will the adesha ityadi, when it uses something there, what all is covered? So an, when the an is talked about, an is an adesha. An is what? An udit savarnasya cha apratyaha swasya. So what happens is that the udit is what? Now we saw idito num dhatu, there we saw id it. So it yasya. Now anudit is what? An ud it. So this an, which is udit is what? Ukara with taparagana is ut it yasya. Just like idit, in idito num dhato, the idit we saw similarly is udit. Udito ut it yasya saha udit, that which has ukara with taparakarana is hrasva ukara. Ukara as an it letter, that is called as an udit. Which are those? So that is used for short forms of ka varga, cha varga, ta varga. So ka varga will mark as ku, chu, tu and pu. So ukara is an it letter. Why? Because upadeshi janunasika, it should be anunasika. The ukara in ku is anunasika. Ukara in tu is anunasika. So it is nasalized. So that udit, it is udit because ukara is it. By being anunasika, ukara is an it letter. So whatever has ukara is an it. So ku, chu, tu, pu. These are the ones which are meant here. So ku is udit, chu is udit, ityadi. So that an, udit savarnasya cha apratyayah swasya, and the anuvritti swasya. So laghuvritti says that avidhiyamanaha apratyayah an udit cha savarnasya sanyasyat. So what is said is that avidhiyamanaha an, when an is not a vidhi, meaning an is not an adesha. So you look at this an udit apratyaha. I'm sorry. So here you look at this pratyahara an. An is a pratyahara. So this an is a sanya. Then what is this? There is another an also. Pratyahara an. See, there are two nakaras. A, e, un. Un. This was first nakara. A, e, un. Then hayavarat lan. So lan madhye api, in the sutra there is a nakara which is an it letter. So an is, this is also an an and this is also an an. There are two ans possible. So what is said is that pratyahara an here is with the second nakara, meaning what? This nakara, not the first nakara. So a, e, un includes only an, first an includes only a, e and u. Whereas the an with the second nakara includes a, e, u, reel, ru, a, o, hayavara, la. So all these letters are included in this an. Therefore, this an udit. So paranakara in the Maheshwara Sutra. Then udit we saw savarnasya. This is sanyi. So this sanya, this ku, pu, chu, what will it stand for? The ku will stand for savarna. And what is savarna? That which has tulya, asya and prayatna. So kakara, which is the first letter of ka varga, will have tulya, asya, prayatna with all the four letters which are following. So ka varga entire is the meaning of this ku. Similarly, cha varga and savarna of cha, chakara and savarna of cha, the entire cha varga is meant by chu. So they are all savarna. So basically ku, chu, tu, tu, pu will stand for the five vargas respectively. That is the meaning of this sutra. And apratya, avidyamana, only when it is not an adesha, meaning it is not a vidhi, adesha, agama, ityadi, and apratya, it should not be a pratya. So all these are mentioned here. Atreva and parena nakaran, only in this sutra the nakara as used in the pratyahara short form is with the second nakara. Every other nakara in the pratyahara and wherever in the sutras you see and, that will always be with the first nakara. So when you see and anywhere in the sutra except this sutra, it will mean a e u. It will not mean a e u real ru he hayavara la. Only in this sutra the second nakara is used for and pratyahara. That's what it means here. So it stands for a u real ru a o i o and then hayavara la. That is, and in any other sutra means a e u, that's all, nothing else. So what is said here in the vritti, ku chu tu tu pu ete uditaha, they are udita, and then by tulyasya prayatnam savarnam, savarna of kakara kha khakara gakara ghakara myakara, so it will stand for the entire varga. Similarly chu tu ityadi. Then parasannikarshah samhita. What is samhita? The definition of samhita is given. Parasannikarshah, the paraha most, sannikarshah proximate, the most proximate sound is samhita, is called as samhita. So when sandhi takes place, there is samhita. There is sandhi takes place, there is samhita, meaning the proximate sound is going to replace the, based on the vidhi, it is going to replace something or the other. If at all there is a replacement in that sandhi, the closest proximate will be the replacement. Why? Because samhita. What is samhita? There is closest proximity of sounds is basically sandhi. Samhita means sandhi. So for example, here look at this samhita. Varnanam atishayitaha paraha sannidhi sannikarsha samhita sanya syat. Only then it is considered sandhi. So samhitayam vishaye, you see this in the vritti, whenever there is a sandhi. So generally what samhita means is that less than half a matra sound is there between the letters, shabdas, then they will merge. That is a sandhi. See, in Bala Manorama it is said that the gap between two sounds should be less than half a matra to be called as parasannikarsha. Why half a matra? Because generally it is said that consonants will consume half a matra. So whenever there is less than half a matra consumed between two letters and also between two shabdas also, therefore, so that is called as a sandhi, that is called as samhita. So samhita is a sanya. And then elsewhere across words it is called a sandhi. Then what is sanyoga is explained in the next sutra. Halonantaraha sanyoga. Halonantaraha sanyoga. So what is sanyoga? Hal. Hal is a consonant. Anantaraha halaha. So halaha is first case plural. And anantaraha means they are not intervened with anything. They are not interleft by anything. So hal continuously, if there are multiple hals, with what? Without a gap of less than half matra, half hal. So half a matra. Hal will consume half matra. So less than half matra, when there are such consonants occurring, then the consonants are in sanyoga. So between one consonant and the next consonant, if there is not more than half a matra consumed, then it is a continuous uchcharana of the consonants, and then there will be this samhita will make between the consonants, that will make a sanyoga. So this Sanyoga is only between what? Between consonants. Ajvihi avyavihitaha halaha sanyoga sanyaha syuhu. Ajvi. So there should be no vowel in between. There should be no vowel in between multiple consonants, and when this obviously the space between the two consonants matra consume, the time duration between the two consecutive consonants is less than half a matra, they are in sanyoga. And here when they are not vowels, there are no vowels in between, but there are only consonant, then that is called as sanyoga. This sanyoga will lead to sandhi. Pada definition is given, supting antam padam. So once you have these vowels and consonants in a sequence of letters which are pronounced without half a matra gap between these, whether it is with sanyoga or not, there is a samhita. And then when do you pause it? When do you have a slight pause of more than half a matra where there is no samhita? That will be pada. So pada will be pronounced, a word will have been pronounced. So therefore the pada definition is called for, which the laghukara brings in, suptingantam padam. So supantam tingantam is padam. And what is subantam and tingantam? Supante yasya, that which has sup pratya at the end, and tinganta is that which has ting pratya at the end. And sup and ting are short forms of the pratyas, which are 21 in number for sup, starting with su, suma ujas ityadi, ending with sup itself. So that is a short form sup. And ting is a set of 9 pratyas, 9 plus 9, 18 pratyas, 9 parasmai padi and 9 atmane padam pratyas, parasmai pada and atmane pada pratyas, they are called as ting. And sup having, subanta is that which has sup pratyaya at its end, and tinganta is that which has tinganta at its end. Basically nouns and verbs which are declined. So subantam tingantam cha padasanyam syat. Subanta and tinganta are called as pada, words which are declined, and only padas can be used in sentences. You cannot use pratipadika or dhatu in the sentences. So therefore they have to be declined words. These declined words are padas, and declined using what? Using sup for noun basis and thing for the pratyas for the verb basis. Therefore a dhatu and pratipadika, when used in the sentence, it has to be a pada. It should be declined with a case and number. So it will translate into English as with a preposition. It is sanya prakaran. So sanya prakaran is over. Then ata ach sandhi, sandhi prakarana starts. Sandhi between vowels are covered now. So samhitaika pade nitya nitya dhatu upasargayoho samase nitya vakye tu sa vivaksham apekshate. So this tells you where the sandhi is mandatory, where it is optional. So sandhi takes place, samhita eka pade nitya. Samhita is a sandhi, as I said, and samhita is what in the earlier sutra we saw, that samhita is when there is less than half a matra gap between the letters pronounced. So then this samhita takes place. That samhita in a single pada, eka pade, in a single pada it is nitya. You should, in a word you cannot break the sandhi. The sandhi is mandatory in a word. So for in bhavati, although bhavati is derived as bhudhatu becoming bho and then a as the ganavikarna pratyaya and ti as the thing pratyaya, you cannot pronounce it as bho a ti. You have to pronounce as bhavati, because okara and akara will be ho ayo sandhi, will become bhav a and then bhava. You cannot say bhava and ti also. You have to say bhavati. You cannot pause between bho and a, nor can you pause between bhava and ti. So that is ekapade nitya. Then nitya dhatu upasargayo. When there is an upasarga prefix and a dhatu, between them sandhi is nitya. So v plus eti will become vyeti. Eti is ingatav dhatu, will become eti. Now v is an upasarga. Between ikara and ekara there will be a sandhi which will become vye. Vyeti. So this vyeti should be the pronunciation. It should not be vyeti. You should not say vyeti, because between dhatu and upasarga the sandhi is nitya. Samasa nitya. In a samasa it should not be broken, but this is for easy understanding. In samasa generally it is broken, but what is meant here is that समासे संहिता नित्या, बट वॉट हैपन्स इज दैट वेन दी विवक्षा इज टू एक्सप्लेन, बिकॉज इन तर्कशास्त्र नव्य न्याय यू हैव टू थ्री लाइन समासास, अ समासा विच गोज अक्रॉस टू लाइन्स थ्री लाइन्स, सो वॉट इज दी वर्ड यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड इफ एंड इट इज नॉट ईजी टू प्रोनाउंस ऑल्सो, सो यू हैव टू ब्रेक इट फॉर एक्सप्लेनिंग एंड टू एक्सप्लेन दी विवक्षा ऑल्सो. देयर फॉर दिस समासे नित्या, although it is nitya, in big samasas it is broken, which is okay, because otherwise you follow a rule and it is not understood, the word is not understood, then the language has no meaning. But otherwise in samasas, small samasa ityadi, you should not break the sandhi, especially when you know it is the word itself will lose meaning when you break, that time you should not break. Then in vakya you can make a sandhi, you may not make a sandhi, as long as the vivaksha is to be explained, the intention is clear to the listener, with the sandhi, without the sandhi, you can decide. So in the teaching or in explaining something or whatever, you know, when you want to convey something in general statement, also general conversation, sandhi can be done between words or it may not be done between words, okay, not within the word. Within the word it should not be broken. Within the pada, it should not be broken. And again, upasarga is technically considered as a different pada. Therefore, between the upasarga and the dhatu, the sandhi should be mandatory. Like in the samasa. So, here examples are given. I'll not go through these. These are easy. Then, atsandhi, yan sandhi is the first sandhi considered. Which is with the sutra iko yanachi. We are already past 11, so I'll we started at 10, right? Yeah, 10. So we'll stop here. We'll take these sandhi sutras in the next part. Huh? Nityavasani nataraja rajo nana dadakkano panchavaram uddhartu kama sanakadi siddhan. ये तद विमर्शे शिवसूत्र जालम. नमस्ते, धन्यवाद,
धन्यवाद.